everyone, this is Shikhar from SS Creations. Welcome back to my channel with another educative content. And today, I am here to discuss a very interesting and important topic, carbohydrates. But before looking into the topic, let me show you something. How is this wonderful looking burgers? And what about this delicious pizza? And this mouth-watering paneer chili? Oh God! Looks yummy, right? So my question is, which of these has least carbohydrate content? Is it the wonderful looking burgers? Or the delicious pizza? Or maybe the mouth-watering paneer chili? It's a tricky question. Although they may differ in fats, vitamins, and other nutritional content, but when it comes to carbs, they're almost the same. So watch the video completely till the end. There's a very exciting contest waiting for you. Carbohydrates are the most abundant biomolecules on the earth. Carbohydrates are mainly found in plant foods. They also occur in dairy products in the form of a milk sugar called lactose. Foods high in carbohydrates include bread, pasta, beans, potatoes, rice, and cereals. According to Wikipedia, a carbohydrate is a biomolecule consisting of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen atoms, usually with the hydrogen-oxygen atom ratio of 2:1, and thus with the empirical formula CnH2O(n). Carbohydrates are biomolecules that are composed of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen atoms in the ratio 1:2:1. We can represent the proportion of these elements within carbohydrate molecules with the formula CH2O. Common sources of naturally occurring carbohydrates include fruits, vegetables, nuts, seeds, milk, grains, and legumes. So before classifying carbohydrates, let's deal with the types of carbohydrates.
There are three main types of carbohydrates: sugar, starch, and fiber. Sugar is the simplest form of carbohydrate and occurs naturally in some foods, including fruits, vegetables, milk, and milk products. Types of sugar include fruit sugar, known as fructose, table sugar, which is known as sucrose, and milk sugar, called lactose. Starch is a complex carbohydrate, meaning it is made up of sugar units bonded together. Starch occurs naturally in vegetables, grains, and cooked dry beans. Fiber also is a complex carbohydrate. It occurs naturally in fruits, vegetables, whole grains, and cooked dry beans.
So now, let's classify carbohydrates.
Carbohydrates are classified into three subclasses: monosaccharides, oligosaccharides, and polysaccharides.
Mono means one, and saccharides mean sugar. That means monosaccharides are simplest sugars containing only one sugar molecule and cannot be hydrolyzed into smaller units. They have a general formula CnH2O(n). Monosaccharides, often called monosugars, possess a free aldehyde or a ketone group, upon which they are subdivided into aldoses or ketoses.
Aldoses are the one containing a free aldehyde group, for example, glyceraldehyde and glucose, while ketoses are the one containing a free ketone group, for example, fructose.
As you can see, aldoses possess a free aldehyde group, while ketoses possess a free ketone group.
Oligosaccharides are called as compound sugars, which are made up of 2 to 10 molecules of either same or different monosaccharide units. Accordingly, they are designated as disaccharides containing 2 monosaccharide units, trisaccharides containing 3 monosaccharide units, tetrasaccharides containing 4 monosaccharide units, and so on. Polysaccharides are complex sugars made up of more than 10 molecules of monosaccharides. Polysaccharides have high molecular weight and often form colloids when dissolved in water. They get easily branched or unbranched.
So, we have classified carbohydrates as monosaccharides, oligosaccharides and polysaccharides. Okay. And we also came to know that there are carbohydrates containing aldehyde group and there are carbohydrates containing a ketone group. So now we are heading towards the structures of some important carbohydrates. First we'll start with monosaccharides, that too containing aldehyde group.
The first structure that we are looking at is of glyceraldehyde. It is a triose as it is a 3-carbon compound. The next one is a tetrose having 4 carbons. The first one is erythrose and the second one is threose. Moving on to pentoses having 5 carbons. Examples are ribose, arabinose and xylose. Hexoses are 6 carbon containing compounds. These include allose, altrose, glucose, mannose, eulose, iodose, galactose and tallose. Just note down the position of hydroxyl groups in all of these examples.
Moving on to monosaccharides containing a ketone group. The first and foremost is dihydroxyacetone, which is again a triose. You can see there are only 3 carbon atoms.
The next is erythrolose, while ribulose and xylulose are pentoses. Fructose is a hexose. And keep a note on the position of hydroxyl group of the 3rd carbon atom.
Structures of oligosaccharides.
Disaccharides are most common oligosaccharides, which are crystalline, water soluble and sweet in taste. Disaccharides consist of 2 monosaccharide units linked together by a glycosidic bond.
Have you heard of reducing and non-reducing properties of disaccharides?
If the disaccharide has a free aldehyde or a ketone group, then it is known as reducing disaccharide. If the disaccharide does not have a free aldehyde or ketone group, then it is known as non-reducing disaccharide.
As far as the structure of disaccharide is concerned, they are represented by a pyranose or furanose form.
The structure of glucose looks like this. A hemiacetal bond formation takes place between aldehydic carbon 1 and hydroxyl group of carbon 5 of linear glucose, thereby forming a closed structure called pyranose structure. And both of these structures are in equilibrium with each other.
Have you ever thought why glucose forms hemiacetal bond and changes its structure from linear to pyranose ring?
As you can see, the aldehyde group of glucose is free, thus it possesses reducing property. If this bond is not free, then the disaccharide is non-reducing. Similarly, the ketone group of fructose must be free, then only it shows reducing property.
Now let's talk about different disaccharides.
The first is lactose. Lactose is commonly known as milk sugar. It is formed by galactose and glucose linked together by beta-1,4 glycosidic bond. As you can see, in lactose, the glucose has a free aldehyde group, hence lactose is a reducing sugar. The second one is maltose. Maltose is formed by 2 molecules of glucose linked together by alpha-1,4 glycosidic bond. Second molecule of glucose still has a free aldehyde group, which gives maltose its reducing properties. The third one is cellobiose. Cellobiose is similar to maltose, but instead of alpha-1,4, it has beta-1,4 glycosidic bond. The fourth one is sucrose. Sucrose is commonly known as table sugar and is made up of glucose and fructose joined together by alpha-1,2 glycosidic bond. It should be noted here that in sucrose, the glucose has alpha structure while the fructose has beta structure.
Let's classify polysaccharides.
Polysaccharides are further classified into homopolysaccharides or homopolyglycans and heteropolysaccharides or heteropolyglycans. depending upon whether they are made up of same type of monosaccharide units or different type of monosaccharide units. Examples of homopolysaccharide includes starch and cellulose. In case of starch, the glucose molecule are held together by alpha-1-4 linkage, while in case of cellulose, the glucose molecules are held together by beta-1-4 linkage. Examples of heteropolysaccharide includes chondritin-4-sulfate, which is made up of repeating units of glucuronic acid and N-acetyl-galactosamine-4-sulfate.
So now we are through with the classification and structures of some carbohydrates. These structures might look a bit complicated to you. Is it so? So what you can do is pause the video and draw the structures in your copy. Practicing twice or maybe thrice will help you a lot. Now we are going to discuss the biochemical functions of some carbohydrates.
Biological functions of monosaccharides. The first one is glyceraldehyde. The 3-phosphate is an intermediate in glycolysis. The interconvention of phosphates of glyceraldehyde, that is glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate, catalyzed by the enzyme triphosphate isomerase, is an important intermediate step in glycolysis. The second one is dihydroxyacetone. Its 3-phosphate is an intermediate in glycolysis.
And do you know, guys, dihydroxyacetone is also used in cosmetics and personal care products.
Dihydroxyacetone is used in the formulation of self-tanning products. It imparts a color to the human body. It also enhances the appearance of dry or damaged skin by reducing flaking and restoring suppleness.
Now, we are moving on to the next monosaccharide, which is a 6-carbon molecule. Yes, you're guessing it right. We are going to discuss the biochemical functions of glucose.
It is found in fruits and honey and is the major free sugar circulating in the blood of higher animals. It is the source of energy in cell function, and regulation of its metabolism is of great importance. The primary function of glucose is to serve as a biological fuel source for the body. All cells of the body are capable of using glucose to generate energy.
Through a series of complex biochemical reactions, the breakdown of glucose yields high energy molecules called ATP. Do you know the full form of ATP? It's adenosine triphosphate.
ATP molecules then provide the energy to drive the cellular activities that ultimately keep the body functioning.
The fourth one is fructose. Fructose is another 6-carbon molecule containing a ketone group.
One of the major biological functions of fructose is it acts as an alternative metabolite in providing energy, especially when glucose is not sufficient while the metabolic energy demand is high.
Now let's move further and discuss some biochemical functions of disaccharides. You remember disaccharides? All those having 2 units of monosaccharides linked together by glycosidic bonds with the removal of water molecule. The most common disaccharides are sucrose, lactose, maltose, cellulose, gentiose. Come, let's discuss them one by one.
The first one is sucrose. Sucrose, a disaccharide, is made up of 2 monosaccharide units, glucose and fructose. Sucrose is produced naturally by plants. Sucrose is present in fruits, nectars, and roots. Plants synthesize sucrose from photosynthesis and store them for future use. Sucrose is extracted and refined by humans for food preparations. It is commonly known as table sugar that is used as a sweetening agent for food and beverages. By digestion or hydrolysis, sucrose provides glucose and fructose. Glucose, as we have already discussed, it is favored for use in energy metabolism, while fructose acts as an alternative metabolite in providing energy, especially when glucose is not sufficient. Moving on to next one, which is lactose. Lactose, another important disaccharide, is a major animal energy source. As we've already discussed, 1 unit of glucose and 1 unit of galactose constitute lactose. Lactose is a principal sugar naturally found in milk and dairy products. Lactase, an enzyme, splits lactose into glucose and galactose.
Do you know, guys? Human milk contains 7.2% of lactose, which meets up to 50% of infants' energy needs. And cow's milk contains 4.7% of lactose, which meets up to 30% of infants' energy needs. Although glucose is found in several types of foods, lactose is the only source of galactose.
Galactose has various biological functions and serves in neural and immunological processes. Galactose is a component of several macromolecules which are important constituent of nerve cells. Galactose is also a component of molecules present in blood cells that determine the ABO blood types. According to more recent studies, lactose may play a role in the absorption of calcium and other minerals such as copper and zinc, especially during infancy.
Other disaccharides such as maltose, gentiose, cellobiose are found in plants.
Maltose is used in the malting process of barley in order to make beer. Cellobiose is obtained by acidic hydrolysis of cellulose. Cellobiose can be used as an indicator carbohydrate for Crohn's disease and malabsorption syndrome.
Now, let's deal with the biochemical functions of some important polysaccharides.
The first one is starch. It is the important and major food reserve in plants. The only purpose of starch is to change into glucose to be used as energy for our body. Second one is glycogen. It serves as a form of energy storage in fungi and animals. Liver glycogen acts as a glucose reserve that hepatocytes release when there is a need to maintain a normal blood sugar level.
The third is cellulose. It is the important organic compound which serves as a structural polysaccharide. That means it helps the plant to remain stiff and upright.
The fourth one is chitin. It also serves as a structural polysaccharide.
Do you know that chitin is the second most abundant natural biopolymer in the world? The exoskeleton, which is the outer protective covering of beautiful butterflies, is made of chitin. You might be familiar with those arthropods like crustaceans, for example, crabs, lobsters, and shrimps, and arachnoids, for example, ticks, mites, and scorpions, and those insects, for example, beetles, grasshoppers, and butterflies, have their exoskeleton made up of chitin. Now, you might wonder that chitin is the second most abundant natural biopolymer in the world. So, which is the first most abundant natural biopolymer in the world? Just find it out. So guys, I have asked two questions in this video. Just find out the answers and write it down in the comment section below. Also, check out the description box below to participate in this contest. One lucky winner might get a chance to win exciting Amazon gift vouchers. So, this was all about carbohydrates. In this video, we have given a brief idea about carbohydrates. Then, we classified carbohydrates into monosaccharides, oligosaccharides, and polysaccharides. Then, we looked into the structures of some important carbohydrates. Towards the end, we have discussed some biochemical functions of monosaccharides, disaccharides, and polysaccharides. If you have any query or question regarding any of these portions, feel free to put it in the comment section below. I will try to answer there itself. And if you end up liking this video, then don't forget to hit the like button. And still, if you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel, then that goes without saying. Hit that red subscribe button and press the bell icon to turn on notifications for future updates. Even you can follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Telegram. We keep posting updates there as well. Until next time, goodbye, stay safe, stay healthy. Cheers. Also, don't forget to check out the description box below to participate in this contest.